West End, all right? So off you go, lads, all yours.
So we've got number two, Jonty Scharenberg.
You've got to say something, boys. Tell us about Jonty Scharenberg.
So I came to the club in 2017 and Jonty had a really good reputation, really clean boy, no real issues. And I came back and he was tattooed, beating people up. So yeah, thanks, mate. It's been good to see the transformation.
Next player I had the privilege of growing up with and he's probably one of the best I've ever played with, and he showed at Sunday and really set us up from inside, and he's still got the best hair going around. So, Matty Sue. Yeah.
The next player, we've been trying to work out how to put him on mute in some of the team meetings. But number four, Aaron Joseph.
The great, stern, sexy, chiseled jaw captain that we've got, Chris Curran.
This is the one that's pretty happy for me to describe. Number six, Brad Agnew. Yeah. So Brad and I obviously took the year off last year to go and travel together and had a few honest conversations later in that piece, and decided obviously to come back, and what a good decision that was. So.
Next up, he labels himself the real Ken Farmer medalist, the wizard, Luke Reynolds.
Still can't get him to come to dinner with me.
Your captain.
Number eight, very, very, very sexy, Marlon Motlop.
Everyone knows this man mainly from social media, beach burrito ads, and just generally being the mayor of Glenelg, Darcy Bailey. Darcy, talk us through Sunday and how you're feeling, and how you're feeling today.
Before we get to that, I haven't had any credit for getting Liam McBean to Adelaide. It wasn't Paul Sandico, it was me. We sat down and had dinner in South Bank in Melbourne, where we grew up, we played footy together, and I said to him, if it doesn't happen, if you don't get drafted anywhere else, you come to Glenelg. I've had no credit, so a round of applause, come on.
Number 10, what hasn't this man done this year? Luke Partington.
This man, he's been around for a while, and if anyone deserves it, it's him. He's as good a leader as he is a gentle lover. Andrew Bradley.
Number 14, Buffhead, Brad McCarthy.
How good this man. He's playing with a broken arm, a broken face, two broken legs, six broken jaws, 14 different teeth. I don't know what else, but how good is Josh Scott?
Number 16, 16, growing up before our eyes. He's now a baby daddy, and he's going to be the biggest DILF I know. Corey Gregson.
We actually don't have a ruckman in our team. We have a fourth midfielder. I've never seen a man move so well at this size. And ladies and gentlemen, Jesse White.
Oh. I'd like to introduce you to the sternest, most horny man on the planet right now, Max Proud.
The big man himself, he's come over from Perth, and what an addition he was to the grand final side. Gucci Gang, Matt Hoover Gang.
Brad Close picked up the black eye from her, and he's been punching himself in the face all week. But number 23, Brad Close.
Old man, he's built like a truck. He's actually one of the funniest people I've ever met, and he's going to have an amazing future. Unfortunately, we're going to lose him, but how good is Will Gould?
And last but not least, trying to introduce this guy together. He's probably the freshest man in Adelaide this morning. He's had about 20 hours of sleep yesterday.
So gorgeous.
Yeah, but very, very beautiful, very gorgeous, Carl Nicholson.
And me.
Well done, boys. Very nice work, Michael Virgin, Liam McBean as well. What we'd like to do is get some photos sorted, but before we do that, I'd like to invite Jake Parkinson, who knows this place very well. He was once Willy Wonka here, but now he's gone to the Sandford. Jake, if you'd like to come up and say a few words to the CEO of the Sandford, Jake Parkinson.
Thanks very much, Soda. Very happy to be back here, no longer as Willy Wonka, but what a wonderful sight this is. Jason Bailey, I'm just looking across the crowd here and then watching some of the boys come up. I reckon the volume might have just gone up in the brewery a little bit. There's a few people have celebrated with some West End, so thanks all very much for turning up. To the West End Brewery, the story's already been told. What a wonderful partnership, 1954. More importantly, I know what it means to the players, and this group here, they've been aspiring to be able to get those colours up onto the chimney, big premiers, have the lock-in in the tower bar, and just enjoy each other's company. And the support you have is just remarkable. Thank you so much to West End over so many years on behalf of the league. To the Port Adelaide Footy Club, Grimmy, thanks for coming along. Thanks so much for putting on or being one half of a fantastic competition on Sunday. I know that there are people who make judgments on Port Adelaide and Adelaide in the competition. What I would say is this. You saw the game on the weekend. You saw the quality of that competition. You see what the Magpies bring to the league. Since the league has gone to a 10-team competition, we've had all teams compete in a preliminary final. We've had five different premiers across those 6 years, and many of those premiers are breaking droughts, such as the Bays after 33 years. The league is in a fantastic position. 39,000 people turning up at Adelaide Oval doesn't happen by accident. It comes from being a strong football state with so many people vested in our wonderful competition, And to all of those teams and clubs that put all that work in, we're particularly grateful, and for Port Adelaide for the competition that you put out there on Sunday. Well done. Of course, 39,000 supporters there. The last 3 years we've had 38,000, 40,000, 39,000. We are the envy of the rest of the country, and it comes from passionate people such as yourself to turn up here to see the colours go on top of the chimney. Thank you so much for your support of the league and of this wonderful football club. Thank you so much. To the Glenelg Footy Club, premiers, I've seen the hard work. I've just seen the hard work behind the scenes to Chig, your board. Soup, you're going to go in there and continue that momentum. To all the board members that are here, Bomber and everyone else that's here, I've seen those meetings, and I've seen those meetings with wonderful support that's come from the city of Holdfast. So to your worship, Mayoress Amanda Wilson, thank you for your support. The club wouldn't be what it is today without the support of its local council and the hard work of that board. Even more so, those volunteers, which I know we talk about how important they are, it's you can't put it into words. The type of hours that are put in by the support staff and volunteers, I know from speaking to everyone at the club that they are so treasured. And on behalf of all supporters, I thank all the volunteer and support staff at the Glenelg Footy Club. Mark Stone, doesn't he present so well? What a thing to have a league such as we do with people like Mark Stone, Chris Curran, your captain, this wonderful playing group which stand before you. We're very fortunate to have a wonderful club such as the Bays. To all players who took place, congratulations. But a premiership doesn't come from just the players that took the ground, the 21 that took the ground on Sunday. It comes from the whole playing group, whether that be those kids that have come through the development teams, whether they've been in the reserves team and coming up and played a game of league football, or they're just around the club as past players. It's a whole club to win a premiership. Congratulations to the Glenelg Football Club. Enjoy your next 12 months of having the colours right atop the chimney. And Pete the painter, so the bloke that paints the gym, he had a little word to me on the way in. He said, "Jake, I'm not real keen on painting it next year. Can you just have a chat to the Bays to see if they can win it again next year?"
Good on you, Jake. No doubt, the Senator competition is the second best competition in Australia, the best statewide competition in the country. And I think we witnessed that with the whole final series. Was tremendous, it was tough, it was tight, and it was certainly better than anything that's been delivered left or right of the borders of us here. So well done to everyone. Well done to the Glenelg Football Club. We are going to organise, before we get you to go around and pull the colours, we're going to organise some photos. We want to get all the crowd involved as well. So we might just haven't heard the song for 15 minutes. It's been probably first time for 15 minutes in the last 48 hours that we haven't heard the song. So what we might do is get a whole bunch of photos taken. If you guys would like to just stay where you are, we'll make sure we get the whole crowd in there, and then I'll give you a heads up when you can make your way around there, and we'll get the colours unveiled. But again, congratulations to the team. Thank you to West End. Congratulations to the Sandful as well. And we look forward to the boys having a wonderful day, and you guys continue to celebrate over the next few days. Well done.